Hello, all you walkers out there. Welcome to another episode to the It's One Louder podcast, where I bring you information about your favorite rock bands and favorite artists, hopefully in a very fun way. So today we're going to get into this band called Sleep Token. Not sure if you heard of them. They're a heavy metal band, very unique, very anonymous. They came out with their first EP in 2016 and have released a couple albums since then, three. And I got a hold of this band probably sort of mid-2023, and I was really intrigued from the get-go. They are kind of a crazy thing. It's nothing like you've ever heard before. They are a mix, I would say, between Imagine Dragons, Ghost, and let's say death, as in death metal. Literally, all those three things, you can find them in one song. It can go from super death, growling kind of vocals to very beautiful, poppy, Imagine Dragons type, Ed Sheeran type with sound within the same song. I found that very, very interesting. Not a lot of bands obviously do that. Go check them out. It's something very unique. They are a British band that came out of London, UK, back in, obviously, 2016, like I just said. They've only done two interviews ever. And the singer, and his moniker goes by Vessel, he interviewed Metal Hammer magazine. And the other interview, the drummer, he's called Two, as in Roman numerals two. And he interviewed the YouTube channel Drumeo, talking about his influences of early nu metal bands like Slipknot and Mudvayne and how those drummers influenced him. So that's it. That's it. Only two interviews ever. And so they're very mysterious. They kind of got that aura. And if you see them on stage playing live, they all have makeup on. They all have masks on. So that whole genre, you know, obviously pioneered by Alice Cooper, that whole horror kind of metal makeup rock, they take it definitely one level more. They're kind of like Slipknot. You know how Slipknot had all of them have these masks on? Same type of deal. Actually, Corey Taylor really admires them and their imagery around them, so he's a big fan as well. I'm pumped to bring you this article regarding Sleep Token from the latest issue of Classic Rock magazine. They came out with kind of a best of or highlights of 2023, and I found this one. You ready to do this? All right, let's do it. Rah. Okay, this article is called Sleeping Giants. They're heavy music's latest masked mavericks, and now they've sold out Wembley Arena. But who exactly are Sleep Token? We chart the rise and rise of metal's hottest new band. Rock music has a thing for the theatrical. From the pioneering eccentricity of Arthur Brown, the face-painted trailblazers like Kiss and Alice Cooper, all the way to the mass madness of Slipknot and the campy devil worship of Ghost, it's almost as coded into the genre's DNA as the guitar. And if there's one band across 2023 who made the strongest claim to be carrying rock's history of theatricality and mystique towards it, it was Sleep Token. The mysterious mass viral sensations are the biggest breakout band to emerge from the metal scene since Tobias Forge decided to throw on a robe and mix black metal visuals with classic rock hooks more than a decade ago. In the space of 12 months, Sleep Token have grown from hotly tipped underground favorites to one of the most talked about bands on the planet. And it seems they're only just getting started. By 2023, they were already positioned as one of metal's most exciting modern forces. Their unique blend of groove-driven, tech metal riffs and propulsive, slick, R&B indebted hooks earning them followers in their droves. Third album, Take Me Back to Eden, was one of the most anticipated releases of the year. But it was The Summoning, one of the record's early singles, that truly produced a spark for the explosion that followed. So that's the song that really got me. A smooth, sultry pop metal banger, it started getting serious traction on TikTok, the social media platform dominated by savvy, hyperactive Gen Zers, who seemingly couldn't get enough of this thrillingly fresh sound. The track began trending worldwide, shooting to the top of Spotify's viral songs chart and racking up tens of millions of streams, which translates to about $47, by the way. By the time Take Me Back to Eden was released a few months later, Sleep Token were the most discussed act in heavy music. Incredibly, the album debuted at number 3 in the UK. And when the band announced they were headlining London's prestigious Wembley Arena on December 16th, tickets sold out in less than 10 minutes. Man, that is so awesome to see that type of energy and that type of frenzy regarding a heavy sounding band. You know, this type of stuff you normally see with the Taylor Swifts of the world, the Ed Sheerans of the world, but I'm really pumped that you start seeing this with this type of music, which is awesome. All this without officially revealing their identities or even ever giving a proper interview. While the band's popularity undoubtedly exploded this year, the hype for Sleep Token was being sown from the very beginning. As soon as their debut single Thread the Needle arrived in the autumn of 2016, they began bewitching the rock underground, their unique fusions of genres unlike anything else in the scene at the time. And even ever since, I don't think there's a lot of bands doing what they do, which is really unique, really cool. Two EPs followed, one released that December and two a few months later. But as fresh as the music itself was, the thing that really added to Sleep Token's allure was that no one had the foggiest idea of who the members were. Wearing cloaks and masks and led by the mysterious Vessel, the band evaded giving press interviews almost entirely. Vessel granted Classic Rock's sister magazine Metal Hammer a solitary short conversation in mid-2017 that remains the only interview they've given to date. I know the drummer too also did an interview with Drumeo, right? They don't mention that. I gotta say, you know what? In this day and age, it's super refreshing to see a band be secretive like this and maintain that mystique and that aura. You know, another band that comes to mind is Guns N' Roses. They rarely do interviews and they really kind of pump stuff out. But a lot of the bands, as you know, right now, especially the ones coming up, I mean, they're showing you everything they're doing from the studio, even songs that aren't finished. They're taping themselves and putting it on social media on like even the process of writing a song. I mean, the guy taking a leak in a bathroom, that kind of stuff. You know, it's almost like an overload of sharing. And this is like obviously the complete other spectrum of it. So I find it pretty refreshing, actually. Although, you know, I'm not as much of a fan of this band as Guns N' Roses, one of my favorite bands. So as a fan of Guns N' Roses, you kind of wish they did a little more of that. But, you know, I get it. It makes you want to see them even more when they come to town. Lifting the lid on the mystical concept driving the band, namely that of worshipping a deity named Sleep, and spreading his message to as many people as possible, Vessel was delightfully cryptic in his answers, quickly poo-pooing a comparison to Ghost, whose own mysterious shtick had helped them become a serious force in the metal scene. The only comparison that can be drawn with Ghost is our anonymity, Vessel noted. Our verses are a token, crafted to magnify and embody the multitude of emotion that writhes in our subconscious. Sonically, our voice is rooted in the resonation between the notes and your emotion. That explains that then. Man, talk about taking it really seriously. The enigmatic aura surrounding Sleep Token only added to the growing hype. By the time their first show took place at a packed out Black Heart Club in Camden, London, in May 2017, they had already become a major talking point. Following a couple of years of sporadic releases and more shows, Sleep Token finally unveiled their debut studio album. Titled Sundowning, it was announced in June 2019, with a new song from the record released every 2 weeks throughout the year. Huh, that's an interesting way of doing it. Until the album was available in full in November. With each song emblazoned with its own symbol and visualizer, furthering the band's fascinating mythology. In 2021's second album, This Place Will Become Your Tomb, was released, garnering critical acclaim and putting the band in bigger venues, and their shows felt less like rock gigs and more like frenzied cult gatherings. Fans almost delirious in their adulations of this strange, anonymous, soulfully powerful collective. Fast forward 2 years and you'll struggle to find anyone with a passing interest in heavy rock that hasn't at least heard of Sleep Token. Where the band go from here is anyone's guess. But one thing is for sure, the way they have so carefully protected themselves and their IP suggests they are taking the utmost care with planning every maneuver. With that in mind, we suspect that the gospel of sleep will continue to spread far and wide for some time yet. Well, there you go. Short and sweet article for you. Just to add to this, let me read you what I saw on Wikipedia just to add a little bit more context. So it says Sleep Token are said to be the mortal representatives of the ancient deity known as Sleep, led by the mask and cloak figure appointed Vessel, the master creator behind the music. Okay, I'm quoting Vessel here, and he states that we are here to serve Sleep and project his message. When asked about Sleep, he stated that he is everywhere at all times. Vessel encountered Sleep in a dream with promise of glory and magnificence if Vessel followed him. Vessel seems like a very interesting character. I don't know if any of you out there worship the deity Sleep. I definitely worship Sleep, not the deity, but definitely love my pillow time. I worship Sleep about, you know, 6 to 8 hours a day, depending on the day. Thank you so much for checking us out. I really appreciate your loyalty. If I brought you value here, if you learned a thing or two, definitely smash that like button and subscribe. Really appreciate it. And I'm going to continue bringing some more articles as I see fit. All right. Rock on. One louder. Don't forget, whatever you do, do one louder, especially when it comes to rock.
A big thank you to Luke Phillips, who provided the amazing artwork and time-lapse video for this episode. Please go check out his unique talent at lukephillips.art. Looking forward to working with him again.